ladies, welcome back to my channel. Today for you, I have a spice cabinet makeover. Yes, I am making over my crazy looking spice cabinet. And I mean crazy. There was stuff in there that I don't even know when it's from. I was like smelling and like, it was bad, okay? So anyways, I'm super excited because I redid the whole thing. It looks amazing. Like, you guys know that have been on my channel, I'm an organization freak, and I found some good products to make my little heart sing and look at it and just think it's just so beautiful. So if you guys wanna organize your spice cabinet, make sure you hit the like button and let me know that you guys like videos like this. Also, don't forget to subscribe, hit that little bell so you're notified when I post videos. Also, I just did a what's in my pantry video, so if you guys wanna see that, it'll be listed in the down bar below. But without further ado, if you guys wanna see how I turned my nasty spice cabinet into something beautiful and magical, then just keep watching. All right, you guys, here is the before. And it was really bad. I mean, to be honest with you, stuff was falling all over me when I was trying to cook. It was super annoying. So what I start off by doing is pulling every single thing out of the cabinets. I start organizing them into categories, sauces, spices, packets, whatever it is that I have. And then I start cleaning. I start ripping all these things out because they did not look good. They were really crusty. I start sizing up all of the shelves to make sure these are the sizes that I'm looking for, and I give it a good wipe down. So I wanted to show you guys, I use a piece of paper instead of a funnel. This is a little trick that I have because your girl didn't have a funnel, but it is not gonna slow me down or stop me. So anyways, I'm just going through all of my spices. I'm seeing what I have. I'm seeing what I have doubles of, and then I am basically gonna start putting them together. Now I got this really cool rack from Zulily, and I got these really nice spice containers to go in them from Amazon. They're square, they're beautiful, they fit perfectly. The ones that came with them, I'm not really a fan. I'll show you guys those a little bit later on, but right now I'm just filling up all of my main stuff. Everything is empty, so I'm filling up all of my everyday spices. This is the rack that I like to have close by because it has everything I need. Oh, I wanted to give my favorite seasoning, my bagel seasoning from Trader Joe's, a shout out because it's the bomb. If you haven't tried it, check it out. So anyways, I use a knife to pop the lids off of everything. It makes it super easy, a butter knife, not a sharp knife. And then basically now I'm just gonna be filling everything up. I think it's important to think about what you actually use and pare it down so it's as simple as possible and the least amount of products. Oh, and I also wanted to show you guys my favorite salt. This is Himalayan salt, and it's only the legit stuff if it comes in one of these bags. So make sure you're getting the good stuff. Anyways, I am filling these up. I'm gonna be labeling these a little bit later on, but I'm already loving the way that everything's looking. So here's a close-up of that rack I was telling you guys about. Now this is the salt, pepper, garlic powder, just the basic stuff. Now you're gonna wonder why I have the same repeats at the bottom, but if you cook a lot for a big family, I feel like when you shake it out, it's just not enough. So it has these awesome scoopers that I can just scoop larger amounts into the pots that I'm cooking. Now I just stuck these behind, like this onion powder, it was old, so I need to replace it. That's why I'm sticking these behind here, and I ran out of smoked paprika. So I'm gonna stick those behind there and remind myself that I need to purchase those. Okay, so now I have this Lazy Susan that I have all of my seasonings. Now what I'm gonna do is start putting them in order. So I have like my Italian seasoning, oregano, I have my fennel seed and my thyme. I just like everything to be in the same category together. So then I have dill, cilantro, cumin, which are more Latin. Then I have curry powder and ground ginger, which are more of like my Asian dishes. And then I have my spicier stuff, which is cayenne pepper. And then behind it, I have my red pepper chili flake. And then I have chili powder. And behind that, I have chipotle chili powder. So I'm gonna label these accordingly. I'll show you guys so you don't forget what's behind. Now I have this tray, and I wanted to do this because like I said earlier, everything was falling on top of me and I was not having it. So I got this tray because this is gonna go at the very top. Now I can't reach it, I'm short, I'm only 5'3". So this is gonna go up top, and I'm gonna just get into it when I need to refill things. And then I'm gonna start sticking things behind that I have extras of because I had a bunch of extras. My husband starts buying stuff. He does dry rubs for our smoker that we have in the backyard. Okay. So then I have, you know, different peppercorns and all that stuff. That's stuff that I don't use on a regular basis. This is my Parmesan thing, and then I got a couple extra containers and some spoons. So I'm gonna just put those in a Ziploc bag so they're not rolling around in there. And then I got these awesome containers, you guys. Like, I absolutely love these. They're for oils and vinegars. I will link these in the down bar below. I mean, everything will be listed. So this is me putting everything inside. This is my favorite part. I close the door there so I can make sure the little spoons fit. But I love this part because now I get to just put everything in and make sure it fits correctly. So on the bottom, I had my spices, my oils, everything that I need to get to easily. And then I have a second set of those shelves and some things that I like to carry. Now, if you notice on that second shelf, those are the containers that came with these little shelves. And I'll show you guys these a little bit, a closer up of that in a second. But so here's the top row. This is everything, my salt. I keep those in the boxes up top. The next row, this is this little stadium thing. It's called like a three-tiered, but you can put sauces. I'm gonna put some Asian vinegar and different stuff in there. I just have to buy the bottles. But I really like that you can see what's behind it. It kinda, you know, does a layered effect, a tiered effect. So then I have my coconut oil, and this is what I was telling you guys earlier. I didn't like these containers, so I popped the lids off and I put our pouches in them. And then with the big ones, I kept stuff that I use a lot of. I have nutritional yeast, oregano, and cinnamon. And this is, you know, what I showed you guys earlier. But I started labeling everything, and I love the way that it turns out. And it's so beautiful. And I wanted to show you guys, here's the larger of those containers, and I have soy sauce and olive oil. And I also have olive oil in this little mini thing here, and this is a sprayer. So this sprayer is amazing. I have another one I'll show you that I don't like, but you just have to squeeze it all the way down, and it works really, really well. Now back here is that toasted sesame oil. I stick that back there, but everything's in that little bin so it doesn't fall out. That is like the key to life for me right now. I hated that. So anyways, now here's with all the labels. It's looking fabulous. And I wanted to show you guys. So here's that turntable again. So I have everything labeled at the bottom, but look, so bay leaf, I have sesame seed behind it. So I list sesame seed underneath it, so everybody knows what's behind. So I can utilize all the space that I have, and you know, we still know what's going on. So like the chili powder, and then I have chipotle in the back. So here it is, you guys. Here's the before. Oh my gosh, yes, it was no bueno. I did not like it. It was dangerous, literally. Now it's just amazing. It feels so good. I just love the way it feels, and plus I'm safe. And you know, it just makes things so much more simple to cook. And I think that's the key when we all live super busy lives, to just be able to find stuff, you know what I mean? But I absolutely love it, and I hope you guys love the after, because I think it's amazing. All right, you guys, I hope you enjoyed my makeover. I had so much fun doing it. I love just seeing how everything looks all organized, and it's easy for anyone to come to your kitchen and cook. Like, that's the key. If someone else can come to your kitchen and find things, you're winning. So all of the links are in the down bar below of all the products I used in this video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that little bell so you're notified every time I post a video. And thank you guys again for watching, because I know you could be anywhere on the internet, but you're here with me, and I so appreciate it. Thank you guys again for watching. I'm always your girl, Lorna Marie. Bye.